Do you tango? ¿Cómo andás, Anthronaut? In our last episode, we flowed into Argentina's Iguazu Falls. Now let's dance our way back into Buenos Aires, Argentina. As you know, it takes two to tango, but what exactly is the tango, and how did it start? Tango dancing grew out of brothels in the 1880s, and this Milonga-style music evolved from indigenous Spanish and African rhythms, such as the percussive Candombe played by Uruguayan and Argentinian slaves. Like the blues, tango is imbued with a touch of sadness and regret. European immigrants helped to further develop tango culture, including the introduction of Lunfardo slang, which we discuss in earlier episodes. Because of its seedy origins, the tango is regulated to the poorer sections of town, until its popular introduction to the rest of the world during the 1930s. One of tango's most famous ambassadors is Carlos Gardel, known as the King of Tango. To get your tango lessons, be sure to visit Buenos Aires' famous San Telmo and the colorful La Boca neighborhoods. Here, you can learn some tango basic steps, have a nice meal, and get some souvenirs for the family. In 2009, the tango is put on UNESCO's Intangible Cultural Heritage List, making this Rio de la Plata syncopated art form both a national and international treasure. When you return from this vacation, you may even rule the dance floor. If you like this Argentinian choreography, show and tell me in the comments below, and then tap that subscribe button to receive future traveling culture announcements. In our next episode, we'll learn more about Argentina's Evita. I'm Mark Thomas for Anthronauts.com. Nos vemos y huyawa.